Yeah. I'm tired of working spots all over the state, moving all the time from hotels, motels, pimps beating you up, taking your money, bellboys making you give them free kids.
Now, hold it right there. I don't know how my girl can talk like that. Couldn't she just say, sample?
Yes, ma'am. Anyhow, I didn't save any money, and these pimps, these, sample salesmen.
Now that's pretty made up.
Anyhow, they took my money, they beat my ass, my, person. And half the time I did get busted, they weren't even around to bail me out.
I don't want nobody around here who's got no more trouble. They asked you for anything.
I don't know, ma'am. I'm clean as a whistle.
Thank you. darn, but I got me a dog.
I thought about Angel.
Angel? Nothing wrong about her. Tomorrow. You see, honey, my girls dress. about the only sit-down place you can go to in town, then only the back two stations. Hell, I'm gonna put my own in out here for the Chamber of Commerce Beach. I'm scared competition is created by those thumb such. Oh, honey. This is gonna mess up my outfit. Oh, Lord, girl. You've got me on the edge of crying. And I've just retired from here. Girl. Get a hold now. Train up.
Thank you.
It's a sales job.
Well, I don't know for sure, Mom, but I should be getting home in about, I don't know, 20 days or something. Can I talk to little Billy? Mama, can we keep the Bible out of this? I'll take them off your hands as soon as you get ahead a little. Mama, please, let me talk to little Billy now, okay?
Oh, hi, honey. How you doing?
Is Randy treating you good? No, honey, I can't get there for Thanksgiving. You should be thinking about you, though. Billy, don't go crying on me. You gotta remember that cowboys don't cry.
Did you make up for this to Santa Claus yet?
No. Will you make it out and get Grand American York for? Because, Billy, I got a feeling old Santa's gonna bring you a whole study set full of slave service this year.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I gotta run off now, honey. Mommy loves you.
We'll see if we can work it out to get cooked around Christmas Eve. All right?
Yeah. I just hope those daddy's still swimming that old football game. Okay?
Oh, that's all.
Look how we think how you're going.
Yeehaw!
Those daddy's so comfortable. It's not near as comfortable as you look at that prairie Hollywood outfit.
Scott, how good old boy last night?
Aw, he was alright.
Yeah, what kind of blazing did he want?
Looked to me like the $8 he was the next special type.
Nah, he gave me $15.
$15, huh?
Well, hello, Mrs. Rockefeller.
Y'all can stop hitting on her.
I know how to feel.
I can tell Mama that I was stopping down.
Well, honey, you ain't mine.
Feel ya.
Mama's gone.
Give it away tonight.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah. me if I'm ever. Excuse me, lady.
Oh. come up looking for you.
Keith Freeman. I'll bet you said Keith Stone better. I got to get myself on down in the courthouse bed.
He must be some sort of reporter. He's looking for you down at the courthouse. Fanny Cutting.
God damn it. You know, this guy takes out me no fun no more. There was a time when law and order meant them. Now you've got to repose them right to them so you don't have blood. And fill out a therapy so the show dog couldn't jump over. I got me half of my kid's bedroom.
Hey, some thing that you got too rich for the job.
Yes, thank you, fun. All I've got my pension and my good name.
And your cattle ranch. And how about that fishing lodge down at Father Allen's?
Ha! We're going to drive you crazy, guys!
Bye-bye, Earl! You don't come back!
Earl, I think they got me this time.
Don't tell me what my goddamn job is, or I'll teach you to stop and go and tell the show! If I even dream anyone you fancy has even thought about trapping you out.
Now it's the hottest thing on the air. Then it's the gun show!
And Austin, there again, what new?
Oh my God.
Hey, Earl. You can set all speed traps and light catch towards. If you went the other way with some little young man still tired of joyriding, you would need to turn your head about more running that place out there. But the one thing you can do, Admiral, is you can go spread the gutter talk on TV.
I didn't know. He was taking pictures!
What did you think the camera was for?
I'm getting just a little bit sick and tired of all this goddamn bad mouth. Hell, the chicken ranch don't give the meter as much trouble as the roller chicken ranch. All them all night stand parties. And come out and take an air hole.
You know, you ought to go get that speech on TV. The season's first screen to end up in. He's a man of
horse crap. He's the biggest industry in this town I ever owned itself.
And the chicken ranch couldn't complete the air and the water.
If you was to show a little guts to your own vessel, you'd stand up here town in your newspaper. Instead of running all that stinky crap about glee clubs winning ribbons and you glee having our free social in the backyard! That's all working well. You guys are just all waste shit! Heck, this morning herself ain't that worried about it. I was out there this morning. They were getting picked up for the Thanksgiving party. Just like that.
God dang it, Earl. That television crusader hit where those football boys get out of home place. I'm moving to Bangkok.
Well, who wants it? If that little 3-foot excuse for a man comes out here, I'm going to fly. So he's got to roll down his sock.
Thank you. Thank you. play.
The Yankees have the ball on the 3-yard line. There's only 6 seconds left. Bubba Schrake, the head quarterback, was so good defense. Andrew Wilson goes wide to the right. Schrake takes a snap, spins, hands off to Gary Conrad. Conrad's got running room. He can make it, and he's in there. He's in for the touchdown. Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle Field is going ahead. The Lublin Wild. And the Texas Aggies win it 13-12.
Yeah.
Of the very fortune of the chief branch. Let me hear his name. Thank you. Three boxes, there you go.
cheaper money you can get in canned beer. Thumb baths, naked massages, nippy sacks. Somebody tickling your ass for the better.
If you know that for a fact, Mr. Newspaper Editor, then it is your duty to expose it.
Melvin, why am I going to give a damn if some poor folk want to get their ass tickled with feathers? Damn, I kind of think that's what heaven's all about.
Bag and kind of poking at me like my body. Instead, he Okay? This means for you. He never was with a man or brother, but I never thought more about Cinderella. Maybe he was no more than a red button, no, but I remember the sun and the blue, blue water, and President Kennedy's breath made me near the clouds of smoke. And the worst fucking thing, but it's an apple! Not you! Adolf never takes initiative. And maybe he's not cut out for it. Not now, anyway. Not anymore.
Well, I'm sure sorry for the trouble you've been having this month.
You, honey, don't feel sorry for me now. I started out poor and worked my way up to Alabama. You just gotta learn to expect nothing out of life. Well, you're sitting next to something, a little something about it. Why don't you do fair enough to the start of time? Don't go talk. You're looking to get a new sister. Why don't you get your gold rest on the ground? Please.
Sounds like a Chinese dick!
up and down the sidewalk to two separate positions. One opposed the Tigger Ranch, and the other to declare a National Historic Monument.
I'd just admire it if you didn't talk to me about some goddamn fatigue until then. I ate it. What are you waiting to see if it's going to make you sick?
I tried that on my dog first. Just thought I'd be able to take a payback.
Neighborly, my hind foot. You and everybody in this goddamn town snooping around like you've been hired to ride a boat or something. I could use me a little goddamn peace and quiet around here. But I got me some hard thinking to do.
Yep, you're under enough of a handicap as it is.
Damn, Sheriff, you can't hear nothing except this goddamn talk about the cigarette. Why, it's like a broke record or something. Cigarette! And what the hell are you going to do about it?
Scrub.
There's some folks just won't do to part with. And I'm gonna say you just leave the lawn to me.
But nobody's buying nothing.
People just standing around come swinging their hands and talking about this damn mess.
Yeah, not having a way here all the time. I ain't no goddamn car a week.
You ain't got but a handful of quarters left, Dad Earl.
See there? I bet you, I don't care what for good. Ain't good for business. Show ain't good enough for the time.
Of course not. And you can't just sit there waiting for a kick. You gotta do something about it.
And now, everybody's going anxious over this mafia scare.
Yeah. They're afraid you'll start lying about it there and see their old coach.
Don't you, mate? It's just gonna have to clear on out of here. We got some men talking to do.
Yeah, do what you mean. You know, you're going to be fine, darling, with this thing so far. Keep up the good work. Be around, different.
Don't you, maybe? God dang it, college over, stretching to bring in the Texas Rangers.
He don't need no goddamn Rangers. I got me a pretty good bullshit detector for fucking damn sure tell when someone has been pissing on my boots. And tell me it's a rainstorm. Goddamn gutters just trying to cozy on up to the Jesus bunch. And keep the television idiot happy. If he's so all fire keen, close him his morning down. All in hell you've got to do is give me one little bit of phone call. I'll do it.
Sure, sure.
Come on, girl, you know you don't have a ball. Hellfire. I wouldn't have no choice.
Why are you sitting there waiting for a phone call? Why can't you just pick the robot on? Do it yourself.
Well, I'm getting just a little bit sick and tired of your goddamn wife. Now you're well enough to keep your eyes closed as long as you got a person on the ground. So why? Go on.
All right. Let's cool down a little bit. You know, we got our man. Consider here.
A man came to just get this goddamn food. Ah, this is Sheriff Duff.
All right, Governor. What they had to do with that? We can handle this thing locally if y'all hadn't let it get on John Kirk. Don't you worry about a thing. You hold the whiskey. Yes, sir.
God's sake.
If I don't feel like a country dog in the city. If I stand still, they'll fuck me. If I run, they'll bite me in the air. Well, I reckon you boys do.
You really gonna do it, then? You really gonna close home and down?
I said I would. Didn't I? There's some cat that can't be put back in his back. Get the hell out of here.
Well, she's a good old girl, and some long, long miles together in St. Lawrence. She never was a clean guy, but she's a good old girl.
Goody-coo-shoe-stuff! All that bullshit turned tail when this thing broke open. Don't claim to be my friend. No. Full of those red lizards run rabbits. So far, I owe them damn people something on them. And I always seem like this. I just don't see the way this thing turned to clatter the way it does. Yourself, so just got out of here. It ate me up before I know it was hungry.
Miss Earl, I made a lot of money. I had a few lambs. I danced a bit. It's just time to take a fiddler, that's all.
God, if I just hadn't cut on goddamn television.
It's over, man. Oh, Jesus.
You like to get right lonesome out there on that farm.
Well, maybe we can come over to East Texas every now and again and hunt squirrels. Or something.
You with the girls in the ride or anything?
Nah, I got my car and you a pickup truck. But you might see if you can keep those music and television boys from having us out of town, if you can be sure to kill them.
Don't you worry about that. I've got them peppers rolled off on my inside of you. I've got deputies and constables, highway patrolmen holding back your fellow on
me. That's good, Earl.
I guess I better get myself on back in the town and start stomping out grass fire.
I know. You go on. Earl?
Yeah?
Do you remember President Kennedy's inauguration speech?
Well, let's see now. Ain't that the one where he said, ask your country not to do something for you? You do something for your country. Ain't that the one?
Something like that. Do you remember where you were when you heard it?
I got Kate. That's from 20 years ago, ain't it? Why?
No particular reason. I just seem to have that day on my mind, that's all.
But I do recollect where I was when old Wild Wolf shot. I just picked up three Mexican kids. They stole themselves a goat from old man W.B. Starr and was throwing themselves a barbecue, slopping on the salt and up for LBJ. I slapped a couple on them little peckerwoods, marched them lockstep back to the police station. Coming across the radio was when Kennedy shot the cat. And the judge is clear. Funny. There's certain things you just can't hardly forget.
Amen to that, Earl.
Now, when old Jack Ruby shot out, I had to look around, and I missed it. Just about the only decent thing they ever did show on television in all history, and I missed it. I've seen them films of it that run over and over. But it wasn't the same thing as seeing something without knowing it was going to happen.
It never is, Earl. Well, I think you'd better be running along now.
Yeah. I gotta be running.
Okay. Oh.